So we ran the model and reduced much of the unnecessary predictor variables. Now let's test how this model performs with an independent sample. This will be the validation dataset. To do this, Alteryx has a great tool found in the gallery called the Model Comparison Tool. This allows users to validate models and compare models against each other. Check out the instructor notes on how to add this to your tool palette. So what we're going to start with is our full built-out Stepwise model. I'm now going to bring in that Model Comparison Tool and show you how to use it. In the M input side, we throw in the model object that we want to validate. So the model object from the Stepwise tool goes into this M model comparison input. The other side is the D side. This is going to be our validation data set. So I'm going to grab the V from the Create Samples tool and plug that into the model comparison tool. Now the only thing we need to configure with this model comparison tool is, what is the positive target class? Meaning, do we want yeses or nos to be positive association, or trues or falses, or ones and zeros? And just know I'm going to choose yeses for this result. As you can see, we have three different outputs, but I'm only going to look at this R output, which is the report. So there's many different results that come outside of this model comparison report. The first thing is the fit and error measures. This tells us the overall accuracy, as well as the accuracy of predicting nos as compared to predicting yeses, and some other different variables that we don't really need to go into too much, yet their definitions are found right below. As we can see, the validation dataset was predicted quite well by this model, and overall accuracy was at 91%. The nos were predicted quite high at 92%, yet the yeses were a little bit tougher to predict, it says, at only 83% accuracy. This next result is the confusion matrix, which shows us of the nos how many were actually predicted correctly as compared to the yeses. As you can see, we had 504 records that were predicted no that were actually no, yet we had 45 records that were predicted no that were actually yeses. This result shows a pretty good representation of where biases may occur. Do we have way more no's that were predicted yeses, or way more yeses that were predicted no's? And lastly, we have some different diagnostic plots at the bottom that we'll go more into later. But judging based off of just this confusion matrix and the fit and error measures, I think this model is quite strong. But before we get ahead of ourselves, I'm going to test this model out against our other models that we're going to create next.